every desktop or laptop computer has got a graphics card to display the operating system on the monitor. But not every computer has got a dedicated graphics card. In this video, I will discuss the advantages and disadvantages for both the integrated graphics card and dedicated graphics card. So, let's get started. Integrated graphics cards are also known as onboard graphics cards. Integrated graphics cards use the same resources as your CPU. For example, they will use your system's RAM instead of having their own RAM. The modern integrated graphics cards are part of the CPU and are more powerful than the older versions which were built into the chipset of the motherboard. Integrated graphics cards that are built into the motherboard's chipset should only be used as a backup. For example, if your dedicated graphics card failed or was installed incorrectly, then you could use the integrated graphics card to turn on your computer to troubleshoot the problem. However, modern integrated graphics cards that are built into the CPU can be used without an additional dedicated graphic card. To determine your integrated graphics card, you will need to look at its CPU's specification. For example, a CPU such as AMD A10-5800B comes with Radeon HD7660D integrated graphics card. In the back of your computer, the lower part, if you see a VGA port, that means you got an integrated graphics card. However, if you look at a bit higher, you should see an expansion slot. If the expansion slot has got openings for HDMI or display port, or it could even be a VGA, then you probably have got a dedicated graphics card. If you have got both integrated as well as dedicated graphics card, then always use the dedicated graphics card port to connect to your monitor. Advantages of integrated graphics card are low power usage. So you don't need to be worried about upgrading your power supply unit. Minimum space requirement. As they are integrated with the CPU, they take the same space as the CPU. Low noise and heat. They are cooled with the help of the CPU's fan. Cheaper computer. As a low-budget PC, they are sufficiently powerful enough for checking your emails, web browsing, watching videos on YouTube or Netflix, and many other single-task processes. Disadvantages of integrated graphics card are poor performance. It means that there is no way that you could use an integrated graphics card for playing 3D games such as Minecraft. Cannot be overclocked. In other words, you can't boost its performance by overclocking it. Uses the system RAM. If your computer has already got low available RAM, integrated graphics card can further limit it. Then in return, it will limit how many applications you can open at the same time. For example, if your computer freezes when trying to switch between two applications, it means your computer doesn't have enough RAM. Limited video port options. Integrated graphics cards can be restricted to only VGA or DVI port for hooking up your monitor. Low display resolution. Integrated graphics cards are mostly limited to HD display, which again is sufficient for day-to-day usage. Dedicated graphics card. Dedicated graphics card is also known as discrete graphics card. Most computers with integrated graphics card will have a PCIe x16 slot to add on a dedicated graphics card. For playing a decent game, you'll need to have a dedicated graphics card. Advantages of dedicated graphics card. Better performance. Can be used for playing majority of games, photo and video editing software, or engineering design software. Uses their own RAM. For example, GTX 1060 6GB, as the name suggests, comes with its own 6GB RAM. So you don't need to be worried about using up your system's RAM, especially if you have already got low available RAM. Ability to overclock the graphics card. Many dedicated graphics cards can be overclocked to further boost the performance. Can be easily upgraded or reused. For example, if you bought a high-end graphics card that your motherboard isn't as powerful, in the future you could take the same graphics card and insert it into a new motherboard. Or if your motherboard is already sufficiently powerful, you could simply upgrade your graphics card on the same motherboard. More video port options. You could connect your monitor using more modern digital connections such as HDMI or display ports. It usually comes with more than two ports so that you could hook up two or more monitors onto the same computer. Plus, the more monitors you hook up, the more powerful graphics cards you will need. Can display 4K and 8K resolution. But make sure you buy a graphics card that supports 4K or 8K. Disadvantages of dedicated graphics card. Higher power consumption. When installing a dedicated graphics card, you will need to make sure your current power supply unit is able to deliver the additional power requirement of the dedicated graphics card. Higher heat and noise. More power consumption means more heat, which in turn forces the dedicated graphics cards to have their own fans, and fans in turn make noise. More costly. Some graphic cards can be more costly than the whole cost of a brand new PC. Require more physical space. When buying a dedicated graphics card, it's important to check whether your new graphics card would physically fit in the available space. Simply having a PCIe x16 slot isn't always sufficient. Some graphics cards are much longer than the whole length of the PCIe x16 and may not physically fit into the available space of your motherboard. Tip: if after adding a dedicated graphics card, your integrated graphics card is still used as your main graphics card, you'll need to go to your BIOS or UEFI to disable the integrated graphics card in order to enable the dedicated graphics card. This is because some motherboards don't allow using both integrated and dedicated graphics cards at the same time. To learn more about graphics card, you could watch my other videos in here, such as can you use two different graphics cards at once, or how to find compatible graphics cards. In order to support my channel, please don't forget to subscribe. And finally, if you have got any questions, please let me know in the comments below.